On the agenda, we have asked to be included the whole issue of the Caribbean Court of Justice. As you know, I had indicated Trinidad and Tobago's intention to seek my colleague heads, the approval of colleague heads to amend the treaty such as it would allow Trinidad and Tobago to have partial accession to the Caribbean Court of Justice as a final court of appeal in criminal matters. I know that the legal affairs officers met in Trinidad last week, I believe, the AGs from the region. The issue was discussed there, but there was no consensus on the matter. So at the heads, again, we will raise that matter and see whether we can get agreement to so amend the treaty. So that's one item that for us is important on the agenda. There are several other important items, of course, security, personal security, national security. Those are issues that have great importance in the entire region. Trinidad and Tobago has lead responsibility. So once again, we'll be dealing with the key issues since our last meeting. I think we've met in Suriname, our last heads meeting there. Indeed, the CSME will come up again. The whole issue of CLICO is another one that will again be with us. I'm very happy to have my new Minister of Foreign Affairs, who is our former Minister of Finance, Minister Dukaran, with us as we will steer through caucuses on the matter relating to the impact on the CARICOM economies by the failure of the CL Financial Group. It has been very bad for the Eastern Caribbean, and we are hoping to find some kind of resolution to that matter.
Are you very hopeful that this meeting here in St. Lucia will produce some meaningful results?
I always live in hope, and I know we'll all put our best brains forward to try to resolve as many of the issues that we can. I look forward to meeting my sister, Prime Minister Portia Simpson-Miller. I understand she has already landed, so I look forward to meeting her later. There are some issues with Jamaica that we began discussions about. We would want to follow up issues relating to trade and, of course, energy from Trinidad and Tobago. Also, Barbados has some bilateral issues which we had raised on the last occasion, and we would want to continue discussions on those as well.
And being here in St. Lucia, I would imagine, brings you a tremendous amount of comfort. You hold Prime Minister so close to your heart.
Prime Minister Anthony was my professor at university, so I've known him for a very long time, and he was a relatively young professor, and I was a relatively not so young student at the time, studying Lord Cavehill. So that we have known each other, been acquaintances for quite some time. I'll be very happy to meet with him. I learned a lot from him as a law student, and this is my second visit to St. Lucia as Prime Minister. I came here when the hurricane had hit last time. We had come in to bring some relief supplies to St. Lucia. So it's a happy occasion that we are here to meet with colleague heads from the CARICOM region.